So, welcome to Pax Europiana. This is now the ultimate video of the runner for this travel. I'm now going to the airport and I miss already Tirana very much. It's really a great city, a big metropolis, and it has improved a lot. It's my second short visit now here. I was 2 weeks ago and back again now for this weekend. I've made several videos, especially what I wanted to say about history of Albania. I could manage now to say about politics as well. Economics I have covered as well. I hope it was all interesting. It's now a collection of about 25 videos where I cover most of the reform agenda of Tirana, Albania, what needs to be done, the currency, the euro, the European consensus, the economic reforms. So I think, and also the land reform and all the historic reasons for that. So it's a bit of a whole collection. Here we are at the Lana River, it's called. That was very dirty and it was really like a dump for wastewater. Now it's really a very, like a small forest all along that has really worked very well. And it is giving more shadow and also important for rainwater collection. In Tirana there's a lot of rain in the winter season, but almost no rain during this period here in the summer. It's again a very hot day in August. Traffic is flowing relatively reasonable because it's the peak of the tourist season and many people here, especially at, of course in tourists in their holiday apartments, but many love to go to the coast or have left Albania to make tourism somewhere else, which I cannot understand because it's really fantastic here, especially for the international tourists. It has a lot to offer. Unfortunately, many things in Albania still have to be improved, but I make the case again, inside the European Union, all these things can be healed. The wounds of the past, the present conflicts and the injustices and malfunctioning of the markets, of the systems, inside the European Union. It's our, in a way, historic mission to do also this, to integrate also the countries from Ukraine to Albania, from Montenegro to Georgia, and these 9 remaining countries for the next enlargement wave on which I'm working and devoted. That's my personal mission, why I do this podcast and this video podcast, obviously, these 9 countries. I've made yesterday the Twitter polls. I lost 5 followers, but I hope I will gain more. I'm absolutely committed to make this happening, a EU of 36 or 37 countries, depending on the United Kingdom returning or not. But these 9 countries, Ukraine, Moldova, Georgia, in from Eastern Europe, also Southeastern European countries. It's Moldova the same like Romania in that sense, geography. And it's of course some different country. I'm not saying it's the same, but you know, you cannot say this one is Southeastern Europe and Ukraine is different, is Eastern Europe. No, this is all Southeastern Europe, Georgia as well. They are European countries, they want to join. I think I made it abundantly clear also in my tweets to Mr. Michel that this is the direction. We have to give the EU potential candidate status to the 3 countries who are currently stuck in the Eastern Partnership, a failed concept. We have to end that and give the EU potential candidate status to these 3 countries, and Moldova, Ukraine and Georgia, and obviously integrate Albania and Macedonia and Montenegro in the European Union very fast, directly, with the help of the integration of the euro as a tool, obviously, in the case of Albania and Macedonia, and then obviously to make sure that here we have a massive progress with the 3 NATO allies inside the European Union. Can be a special assistance in the beginning, like we had it for Romania and Bulgaria. All these tools are well working and established, and so this is the way forward for Albania. And it will be a very prosperous country over much time. It will take another generation, you know, and maybe a second generation to catch up to Central European levels. And ultimately the southern periphery to which Albania belongs, Greece and Italy, south of Italy, Spain, they will be always complicated from geography, from the earthquakes, from the wildfires, from many other geographic factors make life very complicated here. And only in a solidaric European Union, in the south and the high north and also the east and also all the European Union is ultimately about this solidarity. And this we have to make very clear by integrating Albania in the European Union, how I have made also abundantly clear with my video about the European consensus government between the left and the right together. This is, by the way, the Hilton Garden Inn. It's also very good. You have seen that the international hotel chains, when I was active here in 2013, I couldn't convince anybody. I tried it with all of them. Now Hilton is here, Hyatt is here, Marriott is here, and you know who else, but the most big names are now here in this town. This is also a sign of economic maturity that the brands of the international hotels are here. The banks are already here. And so the development is now going smoothly. And also the expectations of the investors are bent towards success. Political stability is guaranteed by NATO. And now also a reinforced effort towards European Union integration is coming up. This would be the Lana River Road. I think this should be continued. I think it's happening here. This is one of the problems here. They have no continuation of that ring road, the secondary ring road. They have now this big, in a way, inner highway ring road. But obviously here, the way this was managed, and this is one of the big oligarchs here, Sali Lari. He is one of the big guys here, and he has built this one. And obviously the point is that here the, you can see the strategic problems are very simple. It's missing the second exit. This road out to Durres is missing. That's one of the big problems here. We are going to, it's called Combinat. So basically here should be the entry point to a much bigger road towards directly to the coast to have a second exit road. And then also to allow the city to grow towards the west, because that's the only real growth area in the north and in the south. This geography doesn't allow, and it's already densely populated. And then in the west here, obviously towards Durres, this should be one big metropolis. And also there, it's needed to have a major western highway ring between Elbasan, Durres and the north, Gruya. These three cities must be linked by a European, that is the Adriatic Highway ultimately. Not to lead the whole traffic north-south in Europe along the coast. You know, I made many videos already, not to have it at the coast in Kotor, but there must be the urban centers, but not directly through the urban centers, obviously, but as a highway ring road west of possible west of Podgorica and west of Tirana and north of and east of Shkodra. That's the way it has to go. And this debate unfortunately seems to be ultimately still not decided. Abasovic said it will be decided soon, so I wonder. But nevertheless, here we are now leaving on what should be a big exit road towards the west, the second big western exit. But you see, it's not really working. And here there needs to be some significant urban planning still invested into this area of the Combinat exit. Combinat was an old factory here, somewhere over there. It's, this area is called like this. These are basically the industrial workers' suburbs of Tirana from communist times, and they need to now to have also some decent highway exit. So that's for the Western Ring Road. I made a specific video about that one. But nevertheless, infrastructure will be done inside the European Union. We are very slow. I've now decided to criticize the EU much more and openly, because it's obviously for me a kind of a real issue, because I love it so much, the European Union and our success. But the last 10 years we are led incompetently and with people lacking the vision for what is the mission, and you know, just crisis management from 2008 to 2021 in a constant array of basically every 2 years a major crisis, from the financial crisis to the Greek debt crisis to the Ukraine war crisis and the Russian attack towards the migration crisis and on the sidelines always this global major crisis, the Syrian crisis, and then obviously the Brexit crisis, yeah, not to forget that big shock of 2016, and then ultimately we ended up in some years of a minor consolidation just to get this public health crisis of the corona as well to set us back. So how many crises I've counted now, from 2008 great financial crisis, the Greek debt crisis, the Syrian crisis, the Ukraine crisis. Yes, of course, the Georgian crisis we have to mention in that context as well. And then obviously the Brexit crisis and the migration crisis of 2015. And Brexit I mentioned already, and then Corona. So a series of eight significant crises and separate one, all with different reasons, but always connected obviously into the Russian perception of the world that the West is weakened, that 2008 was the new 29, and now of course they work intensively, especially in this third term of Putin, on the fall of the West and the change of the global order, which is not gonna happen, but they are working and they are doing us a lot of pain, from Ukraine to Syria, and have also contributed to a lot of other issues via their political proxies inside Europe and outside. And we lack a little bit of a strategic clarity on that one. Here you see the outskirts of Tirana. Here everything has significantly cleaned up. This was really much more urban freshland and jungle and some slums. But here really significantly improvement has been happening, similar like in the inner city. And the urban revitalization that Rama has promised, he has delivered. And this mayor has also done tremendous work, the mayor of Tirana. I have to honestly concede that this is really significantly better living conditions for in terms of urban infrastructure, in terms of revitalization, cleanliness, and this is really significant, yeah. Absolutely, and I'm congratulating this. This is of course much better. Obviously many other things have not happened. Let's not get too excited, and let's be also very clear what is good and what is bad. A lot of things need still to be done, but seemingly the reform capacity is like that. Some things work when there is attention on the top level, but the systematic form of European governance has not been achieved, and that is only inside the European Union, and that's what we need to do. So we need a new alliance between Germany and Italy, backed by the Americans, against the French, who want a different Europe. And it's quite simple, we have to ask for American support to contain and tackle Macron. And you know, if that leads to his defeat, of course, you know, the alternative is even worse, but the French need to be subdued. They cannot sacrifice Eastern Europe on the back of Eastern Europe, make some separate peace with Russia and Serbia, and that's exactly what is going on. And so we need absolutely a strong America here to push the European Union and especially the French towards including the NATO allies, Albania, Montenegro, Macedonia. This is absolutely what is required. And then all these things you see here, what is still missing, I have analyzed all of it now in these various videos, and the land rights and the justice system, much will be done. And the progress in another 10 years will be significant. Yes, and that's also needed in order to keep the hope of the people of a better future alive. Otherwise, my videos will be not very effective, and my talk to the people that there will be optimism and better future, it will be quite empty, ringing hollow in the ears of the listeners. And that would be obviously deeply problematic, yeah. And so that is basically the life here on the secondary road, yeah. The highway I've showed you already in other videos, but so you get an impression about what is going on here and how it looks also beyond the main roads and the fancy main streets of the center. But again, yesterday I was significantly impressed by the region around the stadium and how that was, has developed significantly, really very, very good. The problems Albania faces today with the transparency in the land rights and the accuracy and the rule of law and the things about the competition enforcement, this can only be solved inside the European Union conclusively. And for this, a consensus government is needed. I made it very clear between the two big parties. And for that to happen, all the people cornering the political system since the early 90s have to go to retirement. This includes the historic leaders of all parties. And this includes all the connected personalities. Yeah. There must be the people in their 40s, they must be now in power, and they have to have some free hand. You know, you cannot avoid some interventions, but if people are significantly thinking they should corner systems forever, then obviously there must be also legal consequences. I think this is now what is happening here in Albania at this decisive summer of 2021, and that's very good. Because if certain individuals block countries for too long, that's obviously unacceptable. Here we come to this geography, the mountains in the back of Tirana. It's very good to see on a clear day. You see how it looks. And that's obviously beyond Kosovo, Macedonia. I've concluded now this 4 weeks tour. I wanted to add another 2 weeks, but that is now too much with the travel conditions and my health incident. But okay, good. I will be fine again. I will do another tour in later this year, where I will then show you more of Southeastern Europe. And that's my plan for before the winter. Not to promise too much, but I will try to ensure that I can do that. And then also keep you updated about the developments also, I think I will come back to most of the countries in some tour, but it will be not a 4 weeks tour, 2 weeks, maybe 2.5. Let's see. It's a lot of traveling and it's a lot of, I will think about how I will organize all these things. Good. Here again, you see how it looks in the parallel streets, it's called. That's basically the backdoor street via this region of Kashar, where you come to this shopping center I've showed you already here. And there's basically a secondary road towards the Chediu. We are now soon at the airport, another 10 minutes to go. And so that's what's going to happen in the coming moments. And then we enter the highway here. Goodbye to the palm trees. I will miss you in Vienna. I hope the weather will not be too cold anyhow. It's a bit too hot for me here. I will be then having a climate shock after this close to 40 degrees for the last 4 weeks, back to normal Central European conditions. And here's the highway, obviously. Here the main commercial artery with all the main companies alongside here. And that's also where the administrative center of Tirana should be moving, along the highway here, not to have all the environmental complicated companies which might be here as well. And they should move into in Elbasan. There is a place for them. And the administration centers, the education centers should be here, between Durres. And what is also needed is a light rail system. I talk 15 years now about it, but obviously that's very important. Here between Tirana and Durres, a light rail system connecting the two cities. Promised since a long time. Let's see when it will be ready. And then to have a very clear moving strategy of the administrative centers. Most of the ministries should move towards this line between here and Durres. And not in the center, obviously, of Durres. That's for tourism. but all along there can be all the Ministry of Agriculture, Environment, you know, all the state institutions. The center of Tirana must be relieved, and also here there must be a light rail, and station by station you basically go from the Ministry of Agriculture to the Ministry of Trade to the Ministry, and station by station this should be the direction along this road, in order also to de-densify a bit Tirana, and also give some good jobs and some to the region in between, and so make Tirana Durres to a metropolis connected by a tramway, a light rail system, or some kind of RER, they call it Schnellbahn. In Austria we call it like this, or in France there's different ways for that. And then also a subway system in Tirana that can also happen inside the European Union, like it was done for Athens. And so here, that is the future, obviously, that will take another 20 years. But inside the European Union, all these things are feasible. Outside, we are stuck, and we shouldn't stay stuck. Like this hotel here, for example, is now stuck since 12 years or 15 years. And everybody wonders what is happening. You see, when there is political leadership and clarity, then also this area here, where there is still a lot of poverty between Tirana and Durres, with these administration centers being removed along the highway, it's also much better for the whole concept of regional justice, in a way, regional distribution, regional development, not only having the center, very rich and the touristic highlights, but everybody should profit from these enormous possibilities which Albania has, and so it will be as well. But it will be faster inside the European Union, and also with some better strategy to develop the country. That would be also good. One of them, obviously, is to decentralize de-densify the public administration along this highway, and have ministry by ministry moved along the highway. That would be the best way to do. Now we come to this crossing. And we come to this crossing here to the airport, and then I will also show you the airport road, and also the German business center, which is now here, the Tirana Business Park, built by the Germans. Mrs. Merkel has visited it and opened it. It's very beautiful, and that's, I think, also a highlight. And also the airport itself is a highlight, and also that you should see that this country has a very good airport, and now news actually has a second one, and has very good conditions in the north now. Just this time it started, and then it is here. You see still very good the structure. That's Tirana basically, with Mount Taiti in the back, and the mountains which are separating the hinterland, and then beyond it is Macedonia, and then in the north, of course it's a bit far now, about 150 kilometers, you see the border to Kosovo, and then in the north, another, yes, close to 200 kilometers, you are in Montenegro. 150, I don't want to make a very clear statement now about the kilometers. Now we are in this highway access road, and that's really very beautiful. And it was part of the highway concession some 15-20 years ago. The first time I came to Albania, you cannot believe how this highway, this airport looked. It was just a white blank building with this kind of typical communist architecture. And I was in 98 with my flight suitcase, as a 20 years ago, whatever it was. And I was about 26, and there was a lot of really, the people were malnutritioned in 98 still. You have sunburned, malnutritioned people with very, you know, the 20 taxi drivers competing for my one business trip, whatever, to the city center. I was the last guest who was not picked up by anybody. It was terrible conditions. Now, it's actually, today is the day, the 9th of August is the day where in 91, 30 years ago, in 91, this ship disaster, this overcrowded ship, the Flora, where the Albanians tried to escape to Italy because of the terrible conditions this country was in. I made a specific video about the communist crimes, but when you see still, you know, that they were basically left at the development of the 1940s by this Enver Hoxha's regime, and then now you have 30 years after the fall, and with all the difficulties of the 90s, which was a traumatic and disastrous situation, then obviously it was the case that within 20 years this country has really come a very far way and has developed significantly, and a lot of investment has happened internationally and a lot of support. And when you see it's only 20 years from disaster point to the opening, has really happened only with America taking control of Albania in the framework of the NATO intervention, the liberation of the Balkans. It was not only that Kosovo was liberated, it was not only that Montenegro was liberated, it was obviously also Serbia liberated. It took until the 5th of October, but also Macedonia and Albania have conclusively entered the American world, the free world, by being absolutely logistically necessary for the liberation effort of the 99. And then basically from that moment onwards, Albania is in the free world. And obviously then it was very complicated to get all these reforms done, and it's still today. But that the Americans behave like they own it, it's absolutely justified. And when politicians then talk about against America and make jokes about Gubernator and so this to ambassadors, it shows actually very bad faith. And it's also, I mean, without America, Albania would not be after World War One, and also World War Two. The illusion of the partisans having liberated themselves without American power and logistic support is an absolute myth, via Britain obviously, but nevertheless. So without America, Albania would not be, neither in 1912, 1920, 44, and also 99. Obviously, from that one, it's firmly in the American orbit, and that is very good like this. Germany is also in the American orbit, and so is Turkey. That's a Turkish investment, Epoko University. And here comes the the German investment, the Bavarian family has invested here in this Tirana Business Park. It's quite a big blocks now. It's a new one coming up, and here obviously also a very great location for business development at the entry, very close towards the airport. Now, of course, the last decade, I don't know how well the business really went in the first decade of its establishment, but I'm confident that the next decade will be really very, very good. You see the Bavarian flag at the Hotel Tirana. And then this coming 10 years will be the ones which will transform Albania to a completely new development level, unprecedented in the Albanian history. After the last, 8 years were a little bit slow in some aspects, but blame it as well on us, on the Europeans, on this combination of crises. And now it's time to make it much better, and this will happen now as well. And I'm absolutely confident this will be the European decade. Many of us were dreaming already for the last one. For this one was unfortunately not to be. It was only for Croatia. We were not ready for Albania, and Albania was also not ready for us. So now this decade in the 2020s is the European Albania decade. And in favor of 22, but there must be some conditions obviously fulfilled, not complicated ones, just the currency, the consensus government, and then the necessary reforms will come inside. But the absolute conditions I put is the currency and the cooperation between the two political parties, and then obviously with it to make it possible the big cleanup, but also then the medium level cleanup of these minor corrupt parties on the LSE and Doshi and all these political structures built on collusion and corruption, they must be, of course, cleaned up. And that can only be if the two main responsible political forces work together and clean up the mess. Yeah. And that has to happen. This is now the airport here, very beautifully to be seen. It's very dynamic here, also for tourism, actually quite good, because after Corona now, it's of course not completely finished, but this is after the shock of 2020, now 2021, a much better year for tourism, and much hope and dynamic is coming up, and a lot of good numbers. I saw the numbers tweeted by a friend on Twitter for Pristina Airport. It's unprecedented, the best numbers in the history of Pristina Airport in terms of landing and passenger handling. And also, I'm sure from here, there's major progress, unprecedented and very good. And it's actually a very modern airport. I love it. Looks very Mediterranean. Look, there's a flight landing at the moment. I think a Wizz Air flight. And here's a lot of things happening. Kruja, you have seen already on my videos. I showed you Kruja here in the north, the castle of Skanderbeo. We were up on that. In the back, of course, Durres, and here the main infrastructure hub. Unfortunately, obviously still no Western Highway Ring Road here, and the access road has also a lack of capacity, and there is always a traffic jam here, because it's also in a way the Western Ring Road goes via the bypass of the airport, and that's of course something. I couldn't check in digitally, and I couldn't check in digitally 10 years ago. Maybe that's not happening still. I'm not really sure why, but maybe something is not perfect still in terms of digital Albania, in terms of flying. Here obviously it looks still quite poor for being just 300 meters from the airport. Here that some of the car rental companies, some of the airport hotels. Yeah, things have moved, but not enough. And now this is basically time to get this done. Good, that's goodbye for now. Thanks a lot for everything. And I will post again from Vienna in the coming week when I'm back. And Pax Europiana podcast and video podcast will continue. Thanks a lot for your interest and attention. More to come from this beautiful country in the future. But now it's over and out from Albania. Thanks a lot. All the best. Bye.